Well, hey everyone, it's the Euro Bandit here once again, and welcome to part 3 of the restoration project of my 1984 Opel Corsa 2-door sedan. This part will be about parts. Yeah, obviously. Both brand new and good used parts. Right, so as you can see, this is the camshaft kit. I haven't opened it yet, but this is how it looks like, as you can see. And it's indeed made in Germany. As you can see, you can pretty much hear tiny bit of the camshaft. Beautiful, it comes with a pre-lube and everything. This is the timing belt kit, which includes the water pump as well, obviously by Gates. And I know they make quality belts, and they have warranty up to 6 years or 100,000 kilometers. You can see, here's the water pump, obviously all brand new. There's the gasket for it, and here's the belt itself, obviously high quality. Got this sticker as well, so I can write down the kilometers and the date when it has been replaced. Obviously brand new alternator. As you can see, I don't like buying used parts. It's by CVAM. However, this alternator is remanufactured. I think it was originally a Delco Remia. And this is a 70 amps, which is pretty much enough, because the standard one, I guess it's 45. My front brakes are totally shot, pretty much like on every unmaintained vehicle. And I bought a set of two brand new front discs, obviously made by Brembo. Here's the brake pads, as you can see. This is pretty much how they look like. Let me take out one of the discs so I can show how it looks like. This is how one of the discs look like. As you can see, it's rather small, but it's enough for a car that only has 54 horsepower. Here are some more new parts that I just picked up recently. Two fan belts. Now you may wonder, why on earth would I buy two fan belts? Well, because there's two different sizes, and I'm not sure which of them is the correct one. Brand new gasket for the valve cover, as well as three brand new oil steel rings for both the crankshaft and the camshaft. And here we are a few days later, I just picked up this instrument cluster. I buy it from a scrapyard via the internet. It's in much better shape. The thing is that this is for the deluxe model. It has the tachometer and it looks a bit nicer and fancier. On the base models, you don't get the tachometer. The instrument cluster looks a lot different. So those are the most common ones. These are actually very rare, so I'm very happy that I could find one. Was it cheap? Well, not really, but it was in very good condition. But there's two issues actually with this thing. The first issue is that you can see a crack right over here, exactly as mine has. And the second problem is the kilometers. As you can see, this thing has 72,000 kilometers and the original instrument cluster has 90,000. This is the heating fan, as you can see. I bought it off the same address, but a different scrapyard online, and I just got this suit today, and this thing should be working just fine. These things aren't all that expensive, but unfortunately they don't make new ones. So, you know, at some point the original ones will have to be repaired, and I don't know, I might even keep the original one off the car. And here's two more goodies I've purchased from two different scrapyards via the internet. Let's see. This is the heater control, as you can see. This is how it looks like. Really looks nice. I also found this light switch, as you can see, because mine isn't working properly. This has no play whatsoever. Here's some oil I bought for the Opel. For now, that's pretty much it. Hope you liked this video. If you did, why not? Thumbs up. Check out my other videos, and if you like what I'm doing, subscribe, and I'll see you next time. Part 4 coming soon, so stay tuned.